If you have poke bowls, I will find them and I will eat them all. A Hawaiian dish that has its roots deeply rooted in Japanese cuisine, a poke bowl, welcomes you all on today's episode of Tantalizing Test Buds, guys. Poke means cut into pieces, and that name refers to the slices or cubes of raw fish that are served in a bowl. Poke bowl is exceptionally healthy, full of omega-3 fats, with protein choices like tofu, cubed sashimi grade tuna and salmon, shrimps and many more options. It also has rice, vegetables, seasoning. Dressing plays an essential part of poke bowl. It can consist of unagi sauce, wasabi sauce and many other sauces. If you like sushi, you'll love this poke bowl, as it's free form or deconstructed sushi bowl with much more interesting flavors in it. One can add avocados, mango, pickles, edamame and salad, making it balanced meal than sushi. So when compared to many other choices that can be made while eating out, poke bowl is a winner as it's nutritious, healthy and tasty option.
I know you guys are eagerly awaiting to see the ingredients from which we are going to make today's poke bowl. So firstly, what we need is rice, which is sushi rice. So we'll cook this rice to the perfection, and we are going to season this with rice vinegar, salt and sugar. Then on top, one can use the protein content, and that could be your crab sticks, that could be your chicken, this is boiled chicken, or it could be fried chicken. One can also use sashimi, the fishes which are meant for sushi. Then one can also use a nori, or seasoned nori, or seaweed. Now you get seasoned nori in US, but in Dubai I did not find seasoned nori anywhere, so I'm going to use the seaweed snack, and this is of wasabi flavor. You can have different flavored seaweed snacks. So once you open, you can see these thin sheets which can get crumbled, and you can pour it on your poke bowl. Then we need pita chips. If you don't have pita chips, there's an alternative. These are the toasted chips with herbs, so they really taste good. If not, then if you're living in Middle East, Dubai, where I have ample of kubus available, so I just made this crispy chips from kubus, which can be made in just 1 or 2 minutes in your microwave. Then of course, one need ginger and wasabi paste. And the most important ingredient to which gives the taste, or which is the heart of this dish, is nothing but unagi sauce. So this you'll surely find it in one of the Japanese stores. Besides this, one can also use a seaweed salad or whatever your choice of vegetables. So this would be a complete meal. Now let's have a look at the recipe. When you make sushi rice, to measure the quantity. So here I'm going to pour 250 grams of sushi rice. Wow, perfect. 254, that's fine. So for 250 grams of rice, I'm going to need 350 ml of water. So this 250 grams of rice, I'm going to add 350 ml of normal water, and then I'm going to switch on my flame, and I will allow this rice to boil. I've selected the smallest of my burner, and it's after one boil, I'm going to simmer it for 10 minutes with the lid on. So now let's wait till it boils. And can you see the small bubbles here? It started boiling. Immediately, I'm going to cover it. Make sure the steam doesn't go out, and put your burner on the lowest. And after 10 minutes, we will be switching off our burner, and then we will not be touching the lid or the vessel for at least minimum 15 minutes. I generally keep it for 20 to 25 minutes, so the rice is cooked really well. Let's look at how to make the kubus chips at home. I've just microwaved this kubus for 20 seconds so that I can cut open it. Be careful, it is pretty hot, so either you can use scissors or you can use your hand to cut open the kubus here. Why I microwaved it for 20 seconds? So these two layers are separated very well. So as you can see, the layers have separated well here. Now I'm going to apply some butter. Now applying this butter is completely optional, so you can avoid it. It will taste nice, of course, if you apply some butter here. Just brush it up. Yeah, and then I'm going to microwave this kubus for say 1 minute or so. So it will become nice and crispy. So actually your kubus chips will be ready in just 1 minute. These are our chips, the kubus, and I put it for 1.5 minute here. We will just close the microwave and we'll have, look how crispy they become here. So we will allow it to keep it for some time. And then you can feel the crunch here. Yeah. These are absolutely nice, crispy pita chips for us to go in the poke bowl. You can just see, now you can feel the crispiness of it. It just took me not even 1.5 minute. And these crispy chips are ready. After 15 minutes of resting of the rice looks like this. So you just have to take a spatula and just try to separate it out and take it in a big bowl or a big vessel here and just empty out everything. You should be always chopping it in this way. And try to separate out this rice. Wow, it really looks nice and sticky rice here. Now one needs to season this rice. Make sure you always just chop and fold it inside. So for seasoning of sushi rice is important, and for seasoning, as I mentioned in my ingredients list, we always use rice vinegar. Rice vinegar is very important because it keeps the sushi rice moist and sushi also fresh. Okay, now for the seasoning purpose, I have taken vinegar and I have taken salt. Generally, sugar is also added into this mixture. And in case if at all you take sugar, make sure that you heat warm this mixture so that sugar melts completely. Now we are going to season this rice, and slowly we are going to sprinkle this rice, the vinegar, over the rice so it goes everywhere. And just don't pour it, just go on everywhere. This is very important. Okay, once this is done, again you can fold it in. So the rice gets seasoned well, then it's still the sticky rice and it's getting cooled down also. So this is the basic preparation for our sushi rice. We'll start making a poke bowl. The first ingredient which goes inside is of course the sticky sushi rice. Now you can see the seasoning is absorbed in rice well. Okay, so there goes our sushi rice. I'm going to add my crab sticks here. I'll put it at one side here. Now the quantity depends completely on you and your choice, how much do you like it. So there goes our crab sticks. Then I'm going to use this nori, or you can call it seaweed. As I said, this really is nice and crunchy. So I will just squish it and put it here so it will give us nice flavor. So there goes our nori or seaweed. Then goes our pita chips here. At the side, I'm also going to use some seaweed salad here. This is my all-time favorite, seaweed salad. Then goes our ginger. You can put the quantity as per your liking. I'll put the wasabi, a slight wasabi at the corner. And then comes the seasoning part, which is our unagi sauce. And there it goes. Bowl is ready. As you can see, it really looks so tempting. I'm just going to dig it in soon. Let me know how do you like it. Do make it and enjoy it.
I hope you enjoyed today's episode. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and make.